Students, in this video we will learn about internet. So as an introduction, you know about the internet. So some of us already know about the internet. The internet is the biggest network of computers. So here, how can we define internet? The internet is the biggest network of computers. Many small networks of computers are connected together to make a global network of computers, which has millions of computers in it. Building the internet. Internet is not owned by anybody as a whole. So here we are understanding internet, okay? Many small networks of computers, that means so many computers are connected together, okay, to make a global network of computers, which has millions of computers. That means so many computers in it, and they are building the internet. Internet is not owned by anybody as a whole. So there is no single owner of this internet as a whole. Now let us learn the uses of the internet. Internet is an easy way to get information from all over the world. It provides numerous facilities to its users. It is very helpful to people. Let us learn about some uses of the internet. So before we learn the uses of internet, internet is an easy way to get information. So very easy to get information in the internet from all over the world. For example, if you want to get the information about news of different countries, so you also can get the information about different countries. So let us learn the uses of internet. First, searching information. We can search, or you can search for any information over the internet. So any kind of information that you want to search, you can find it in the internet. Second, communicating with people. Email, voicemail, online chatting are all methods of faster and cheaper means of communication. Communication means sending and receiving the messages. Okay, through email you can send, through voicemail you can send, and you also can receive the reply of the other persons. Online chatting, many of you already know online chatting, are all methods of faster and cheaper means of communication. Third, meeting people. You can meet people using the internet. So like in the TV channel, you can see different news channels are there. So one is sitting in another country or the city, and one is in another. So they are able to get the news from different places in one place. So they are meeting in the internet. Entertainment. Next one is entertainment. Online games, quizzes, music, movies and videos are all available on the internet. So many of you are aware of that. We are able to get different types of online games, quizzes, music, movies and videos. They are all available on the internet. The next one is discussion forums. Like-minded people can form groups together to discuss topics of interest. So here different people can form a group and discuss the topics together according to their interest of like some business, if they want to do the business, or any particular topic they want to discuss using the internet, they can do it. The last one is education and learning. Okay, education and learning. Internet is a great tool for online learning and courses. It is also a reservoir of information. Reservoir means that is a storage. Okay, so many informations are available, are stored. Okay, that is why we are calling it reservoir of information. So any kind of information that is there in the internet. So this is called e-learning. So now nowadays we are getting different types of topics on the internet. Okay, study materials also we are able to get. So most of us are learning electronic learning using the electronic learning, that is e-learning. So I hope all of you have understood.